Oh, we're rolling. What is up, YouTube? Welcome back to yet another video. Ryan here. So don't ask me how I got here, but somehow I found myself on the planet Endor. Remember that foresty planet at the end of Return of the Jedi where the cute little Ewoks are running around making the stormtroopers wish that they were never born? Just kidding, I'm actually in my hometown of Santa Cruz, California, taking in this beautiful scenery as summer approaches us. But today is May 4th, and for those of you that don't know, May 4th is Star Wars Day. So I'm here, thought I would make a video to say to you guys, May the 4th be with you.
Use the Force, Luke.
No, I said the 4th. So let's take a minute to talk about a cornerstone in our culture that has impacted the lives of trillions and quintillions of people, including myself. You guessed it, people. Star Wars. The ultimate tale of good versus evil. The lesser fortunate underdog turned hero overnight who saves the universe and gets the girl in the end. Or makes out with his sister. It's because I was graced enough by destiny to be exposed to the wisdom and the philosophical themes behind this legendary series at an early time in my life. And honestly, I have yet to see anything that establishes a moral compass better than Star Wars. Because really, there is no better portrayal of the relationship between good and evil, mind and temptation, and the oneness of all things.
But what about the Bible?
Let me ask you this. Does the Bible have pod racing? Does the Bible have hot alien chicks? That's right, I didn't think so.
And you are part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor. Take it away!
Okay, now in all seriousness, let's get to the topic of the video at hand. So the question is, how does Star Wars help us to lead a better life? Well, for those who have seen them all, and yes, I do mean the prequels and the sequels, which by the way make up two-thirds of all of the films, so I would say a true Star Wars fan embraces them all. Anyway, each episode is jam-packed with profound wisdom and spiritual undertones. I mean, think about it. Jedis are Buddhist monks, the Force is source consciousness within us all, and as Obi-Wan would have us all know, smoking cigarettes turns you into this guy.
You want to buy some death sticks?
You want to go home and rethink your life?
I want to go home and rethink my life.
So ever since I was a kid, and well, even up to now, low-key, I always wanted to be a Jedi. And it wasn't until I started meditating on a regular basis that I realized how very spiritual Star Wars is. And now, as I see it, the more we develop a personal spiritual practice, I honestly feel we are as close as we can come to experiencing life as a Jedi. I mean, realistically, we'll never be able to lift an X-Wing out of Yoda's swamp with the Force, but by becoming more in tune with our surroundings and maintaining awareness, we can pass into the realm of flow, which might as well be the Force, in this universe at least. For the record, the fact that Star Wars doesn't have mosquitoes, or at least as we know, makes me want to live in that universe all the more. It's pretty clear to me that Jedis were masters of mindfulness, whereas the Sith seem to be totally consumed by the past and the future, and totally attached to their power and greed. I mean, just look at the rise and fall of Anakin Skywalker, for example. He starts out with loads of potential, enough to be called the Chosen One. He becomes angry, impatient, entitled, and overly fearful, leading him to self-sabotage, and even worse, unintentionally killing Padme and becoming the very menace that he swore to destroy. And the sequence is honestly so symbolic to how we ourselves relate and respond to our demons within. I guess he should have listened more closely to Qui-Gon when being delivered this inspirational quote similar to something out of an Eckhart Tolle book.
Remember, concentrate on the moment. Feel, don't think. Use your instincts.
By the way, if any of you guys have yet to watch the documentary entitled Empire of Dreams, go on to Disney Plus right now and give it a watch, because it is loaded with interesting facts and tells the story about how Star Wars itself came into existence. Anyway, there's this part in one of the interviews where George Lucas states that he was fascinated with studying Eastern philosophy at the time that he was writing the first Star Wars movie, specifically Buddhism and Taoism. And this really is no secret, because George Lucas himself claimed that these philosophies were a huge influence into what would become known as the Force. To reference the more recent sequels, in the latest episode, Rise of Skywalker, Rey struggles with her identity, discovering that she is blood-related to the infamous Darth Sidious. And due to this unexpected connection, she strongly feels the dark side within herself, and even uncontrollably lets some of it out. And this is so relatable, because if you've ever done any sort of introspection before, it's plain to see that we all have a little bit of dark side within us. Or you have a lot of it, but as Star Wars clearly shows us, a life of the dark side sucks and isn't easy. So check yourself before you wreck yourself. And my ass hurts, so I'm gonna change angles once again. 1 second. Okay, back to square one. Anyway, there's an inherent balance within us that holds our light side as well as our dark side. Much like our conscious versus our unconscious mind, as famous psychoanalysts Sigmund Freud and Carl Jung would put it. But as the unconscious or the dark side creeps in, it begins to dominate us, making us slaves rather than masters of ourselves. And we can also see an example of this in Empire Strikes Back, when Luke enters the cave and comes face to face with Darth Vader, and is absolutely mortified to see an image of his own face on Darth Vader's when defeating him in a duel. And so what does this all mean? Well, nothing, until you let it. But also, don't get into a lightsaber duel with your dad unless you want to lose a limb. Or with your best friend if you're surrounded by lava and pissed at him for talking about you behind your back to your girlfriend. So, as you can see, Star Wars has an endless array of spiritual themes that make you really think about existence and your own path in this universe. There's really just too many to count, but what I do know is that by pretending to be a Jedi, you just might find yourself having a more peaceful life. One that is stoic, compassionate, brave, and tactful. So, moral of the story is, if you're looking for ways to live a better life and you have yet to watch every single episode in one sitting 8 times? No, I haven't done that before. Why do you ask? Is that weird? Well, they just released every single episode on Disney Plus, so what are you waiting for? Get going. I promise that's the only homework that I'll ever give you. And no, I promise this video is not sponsored by Disney Plus by any means. But hey, Walt, if you feel like forking over some monetization, I won't say no to that. Anyways, to wrap things up, I just want to wish you guys a merry, happy, jolly Star Wars Day. Go out and celebrate and watch your favorite episode, or all of them. And after doing so, spend a little time to think about the lessons that you learned. See if Uncle Obi-Wan can teach you a thing or two about life. And above all, hope you guys are staying happy, healthy, and creative. As always, please click that subscribe button down below so that you don't miss out on any new content. Trust me, it supports me more than you know. Like this video, leave a comment, let's get into a conversation. And I gotta get out of this forest, because I'm getting eaten alive by mosquitoes, and it doesn't feel too hot. So I will see you guys in my next video, coming soon. Okay, that was the lamest thing that I've ever done in one of my videos. Won't happen again, I promise.